Raising kids is a financial commitment, but so is the process of delivering a baby.
In fact, according to the International Federation of Health Plans, it's more expensive to give birth in the U.S. than anywhere else. Consumer reporter Jennifer Profit shows us how to prepare for this trip to the hospital.
Yes, your health insurance will likely cover the bulk of it, but whenever we spend significant time in the healthcare system, such as prenatal care and delivery, you need to know exactly what is and isn't covered.
But it's not just the delivery, it's what leads up to that, and then what happens after that little precious bundle of joy is here.
Financial professional Mindy McIntosh helps walk expecting families through their health insurance options. She says if you are in that stage of life, it's time to take a look at your health care coverage.
What is your copays? What are deductibles? What is coinsurance? Do you understand that terminology?
These are your out-of-pocket expenses. Copay, what you'll pay at the time of care. Deductible, how much you have to pay before your insurance kicks in to cover larger portions of your bills, and coinsurance. After your deductible has been met, this is the percentage of a medical charge you pay, with the rest being paid by your insurance.
Could your payment plan, some of the physicians, some of the hospitals allow you to set up a payment plan, where in Michigan, a lot of times, as long as you're attempting to pay it back, so let's say you're paying $50 a month on it, it keeps you out of collections because you're making an effort and you are paying it down.
Next, see if the health providers you're working with are in-network. That means they're contracted with your health insurance, and if they're out-of-network, your insurance might cover a portion or none at all. This is all determined by your specific insurance situation.
But like Blue Care Network or some of the HMO type of plans, you need to make sure that you have different referrals. So if you're seeing your OBGYN and need some other type of gestational referral, let's say, they have to be in the network or you're going to pay higher charges or sometimes not be covered if you go to a hospital, facility, or physician that does not accept your type of insurance.
Time's Money magazine looked at how the cost of birth changes per state, and they found in Michigan your insurance is billed more than $5,800 on average for a, quote, normal delivery. C-sections are nearly $3,000.